Hey everyone, so I know many of you watched my content exposing James Tour and his lies regarding origin of life research. I also know that many of you have been anxiously awaiting some news as to whether James and I will be having a live debate on this topic. Well, after a month and a half of excruciating back and forth by email, I am pleased to announce that a live debate has been confirmed. I won't bore you with the entire 50-plus email exchange, but there were some hilarious moments in getting to this point that were too good not to share. First, here he is trying to suggest that any discussion be done without reference to slides or research, and that we just draw structures on blackboards. So he wants a discussion of origin of life research where we do not refer to any origin of life research. You know, for clarity. He also wants to load the title such that if science doesn't immaculately explain every last little detail of the origin of life, which we all know it doesn't, he wins. After some more back and forth, we got to here. He said mentioning worldviews and motivations is forbidden. I said that's stupid since his religion is the reason he lies. He accepted. I said it's idiotic to do this without referencing literature, and I will reference any literature I please, so long as it is provided well in advance. He accepted. I suggested the title, Are We Clueless About the Origin of Life? He didn't like it. I reminded him that this is his mantra. He accepted. He tried to erase open discussion from the format, and then whined about my language. We were back and forth for quite a while on the open discussion thing, where he repeatedly pretended that there's no such thing as a debate where the two people actually talk to each other in real time. Eventually he caved, knowing he had no leg to stand on. At that point, we pretty much reached an agreement on format. We were discussing logistics, and then he pulled another stunt. I sent him some papers I would reference, and he flipped out, saying we would only discuss the papers in my initial two-part response to him. So, nothing in my new series, nothing in his content, just those. I promptly reminded him what he had already agreed to, and he started having a total meltdown. After another lengthy back and forth, we are now back to where we already were. Finally, with the format and guidelines settled, here is what we've agreed upon, so he can't change anything at the last minute. As you can see, we've got some opening statements, and then sections for presenting specific prompts, followed by open discussion on each one, then Q&A at the end. It is astounding that it took 6 weeks to get to this point, but you can imagine the delays on his end, running every little decision by his Discovery Institute cronies. Anyway, here are the details for the debate. It will take place Friday, May 19th at 7 p.m. in Keck Hall, room 100 on the Rice University campus in Houston, Texas. This event will be open to the public and free to attend, so if you're watching this and you live in the area, I'd love for you to come out and watch. You'd better believe that James will be trying his hardest to pack the seats with his congregation, so a little bit of evening things out will be rather desirable. I'll be hanging out for a bit after the debate and will be happy to talk with anyone, and of course I'll be obtaining the footage and publishing the exchange on my channel soon after. Anyway, that's it for now. Hope to see you there.